When a person drinks, there are all sorts of indicators that what alcohol does to the brain is not good. Slowed reaction time isn't a case of the alcohol acting on the muscles, it's alcohol acting on the central nervous system from the top down, if you will. Poor coordination and slurred speech, same thing, and we certainly don't get any smarter when we're drinking. It breeds bad judgment. The short-term impairments can escalate into persistent serious brain damage over the long term. This cerebellum at the back of your head coordinates movement, the frontal lobe up here, learning, memory, and cognitive skills. Now, moderate drinkers produce 40% fewer new brain cells to repair alcohol-related damage in those regions. Nowhere is that more evident in the treatment protocol for traumatic brain injuries, or TBIs, and in their case, it calls for zero alcohol, because alcohol slows the healing, it increases the risk of seizures, and it also increases depression and the likelihood of another traumatic brain injury. By the way, 1/3 to 1/2 of traumatic brain injuries occur to people who are under the influence. Goes back to that poor judgment thing. Future Sobriety 60s are going to cover problems between alcohol and mental health, blackouts, and memory. I'm Scott Stevens. This is the Sobriety 60.